It's me, Mikey Pipes, with Peter Piper Plus One. We're back, Monday. Oh, why does it keep doing this?
Compass
watch. Monday, November 7th, 2022. Tomorrow is November 8th. So do your obligatory duties. Obligatory?
Obligatory.
Do your duties as a U.S. citizen and make sure you vote. Go out and do it tomorrow. I don't believe in early voting, this nonsense, but make sure you go out tomorrow. It is your right as an American citizen, if you're in the United States, and if you are here with paperwork that makes you a citizen, make sure you vote, okay? Your vote does count. Don't let anyone else tell you that. Don't let anyone else intimidate you about that either. Make sure you vote. We're not going to talk about politics.
I'll be voting.
I'll be voting, too, tomorrow. Today, we're back. We're going to put in a drop ear elbow here. We're going to come up across, and we're going to do it all in sweat copper half inch. Look, there's my half inch copper, and we're going to connect it to this steam generator right there. It's going to be epic. Stick around. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Let's get going. I'm going to sweat some pipe.
Okay. First things first, we're going to have some, just go over some basic tools, identification.
Scratchy paper. I call it scratchy paper. This is open mesh grit cloth. We have a deburring tool. We have lead-free solder. We have flux. We have a B-tank with the turbo torch attachment. Okay, turbo torch. We're going to use the smaller bit. Smaller tip. There's a tip in here somewhere. Oh no, it's not here. Not here.
Does Danny have it?
Maybe. Oh well, we're gonna use this tip instead. This is a regulator. Right now it's fully open and the tank is closed. So we're gonna open the tank. I just do it a quarter turn. Right? Okay? And then we're gonna open this up. Fully. Okay? Good. Now, I am going to solder this half inch drop ear elbow onto this pipe. The first thing we're gonna do is gonna take a wire brush. Get that in here. Oh, I found the little tip. I found the tip. Look, Peter.
And I found the wire brush.
That's not the wire brush. Do you think this is a wire brush?
That's not a wire brush?
What do you see Mike's? Do you ever see Mike solder? No, but we don't. We usually pro press.
Yeah, it's usually press.
This is not a brush. This is a brush of something else. But this is the tip we're gonna use. The little sparkies in there. It's not in a striker. But we're going to take this tip off. I'm going to use that lighter. That little butane lighter. Just to light this because I don't have a lighter because I don't smoke anymore. So I don't have a lighter or any forms, means of sparking a flame. But normally you would take a quarter turn brush, mm-hmm. which we have plenty in the shop, by the way. And I'm just going to clean the inside of this fitting. Now, this is not the right way, but this does work. So if it works, it's fine. Mm-hmm. But a quarter turn wire brush would be better. So that's that. Now, we're going to take this end of this pipe right here, and we're going to clean this, like this, okay? Mm-hmm. Just like that, nice and clean. Now, I'm going to take my deburring tool, because you want to get rid of that burr inside, like that, okay? We're going to take some flux. We're going to apply flux on the exterior of the tubing and on the inside of the fitting, okay? There's absolutely no need to clean the outside of the fitting. I've seen some people do that, like Kelvin.
Yeah, I think I've done it.
Right?
Yeah.
You might have done it as well.
Just for the radiator we did.
Right? Yeah. But there's no need to clean the outside. Now we're going to put the fitting over the pipe like that. Okay? Now, I have my nice size tip for this. I'm going to turn on the gas and light it. Now, take a look at the flame. You know, we go all the way up here with it, which you may or may not see in the camera, but this is hot. It's even hot up here.
Yeah.
Right, but right here, this is not optimal heating temperature. You want to touch the pipe with right there, the cone of that blue. That's where you want the fitting. That's where you want to heat the fitting, right there. Okay? So as you see, I'm going to bring the torch to the fitting, and that cone of the tip of the flame is going to heat the fitting, and we want to evenly distribute it around the fitting that we're heating up, right?
And because this is a brass, a malleable brass fitting, unlike a copper fitting, it's going to take a little bit longer to heat up, but... And we're going to apply our copper, just like that. Give it a little extra heat as we go along. Right like that. Okay, keep rolling. Now, let's take a look. We'll spin all the way around. A little too much solder, but it's fine. It's not snotty, but we go all the way around. And what I like to do, and this is also kills the brushes, is put a little dab of flux on it. Just gives it a quick little shot. Now, before we move on to the next, we're going to take a wet, damp rag, and we're going to wipe this off. If we don't wipe it off, it's going to turn green, because the acid in the flux is going to interact with the oxygen and the copper, and it's going to cause that to turn green, and we don't want to do that.
Yeah, no.
Okay?
Okay.
Let's do the next. Sizzling. Okay. So we're going to wipe this down, right? We also don't want to do it immediately. You want it to cool off a little bit so you don't shock the joint, because you may cause the... That never happened to me, but it may cause the solder to crack. Yeah. Okay. So now that's nice and done, we are going to put this in, and then we're going to do a few more joints on this length of pipe, because we're going to do a steam generator line from here up with 245s, across, and then down. That's how you do it, ladies and gentlemen. You say Mikey pipes don't know how to sweat pipe. Smash that thumbs up button. Smash it.
All right, we have two more joints left here to make. All right. And if I had some Mickey Mouse's, we could put it in there, but we don't. Is that going to fit there? We want to have a little bit of pitch there. Let's take this piece of black there instead. We need to elevate this a little bit because the steam... needs to go up, all right? And as it drains down, we don't want any pockets of traps when the steam is traveling. Okay, so I have this half inch elbow and that half inch elbow. I'm gonna do the last of the two right here. Again, you should be using a Sparky or a Striker here.
That's my Striker. Remember, pay very close attention, the tip of the flame, that cone, that's where you want to be in the solder. So if you look at the side view right here, and start keeping it right there, and we're going to heat that up just enough, so it catches it, removing the flame, bringing it back. We don't want to continuously keep the flame on such a small pipe, so we risk burning the fitting. Okay? Now the bottom. When I'm soldering from the bottom here, the solder is going to want to be sucked into the fitting. Don't worry about gravity. Right? The solder wants to be sucked into the fitting, just like that. Okay? A little snotty there, but you'll be all right. Okay? Over here, same thing. The cone of the flame. Take the heat away. Finish the joint. If it doesn't melt anymore, bring the flame back. Bring that heat back. Right there. Last but not least. It should be really hot already, which it is. And there we have it. Easy peasy. Let that cool for a good 5 second count. Throw a little flux on there. Okay. Then we're going to take our wet rag and cool that off. And wipe it, flux off of it as well. We're cooling it off and we're also wiping the flux. Most importantly, we're wiping the flux. We don't want to turn green like the Statue of Liberty. So that, ladies and gentlemen, that is how you solder some pipe.